میگم ایشون
یتیم زیو
رجت تاز زیو اول فرام دی کرو از هیر سوری آی کانٹ سی
ابو
او ابیلاشا منجلا رجت دا یو پلیز I have to, there's a special word for Rajata because we shot the film in real locations, absolutely in the slums. And for the first time I was surprised when he found the location, we went there. So I said, kya karoge? He says, sab ready hai, tum shoot karo, mera isme kuch kaam nahi hai. But then he would do his magic and that used to be really great magic. Yeah. And Abhilasha, Hi guys.
Kannu, Kannu ki mummy, Jayanti sir and Rakesh sir will be on stage. Acha, photograph with the cast and Rakesh sir. Nachi. We'll start with the Q&A. Only StarCast picture, only StarCast. Arunaji, once more.
Hello.
Hello. My question is to Rakesh sir. Straight sir. Pooja. Pooja, you're from India News sir. So last year I remember taking your interview in the slum areas of Ghatkopar and looking at the location, I'm sure there was a lot of research done and efforts were taken. So firstly, congratulations. The trailer is very interesting and it sends a good social message across the audiences. And this is soon after Akshay Kumar's Toilet film. So do you think there will, this film will bring a big change in India?
I don't think you make films for change. You tell stories because you feel you want to express something. So it's not about change. And this is, once again, it's not a film about toilets. I'm happy that there was a movie called Toilet Ek Prem Katha and people are picking up very unique subjects. But this is a film which we need to feel for the women, and to say that it's for their safety will be belittling it. It is hame jo hamari mansikta hai, the consciousness needs a shift as to how we look at women, and I think it's something more than just slum safety toilet. It's not that. Yeah.
राकेश जी, यहाँ फिल्म में माँ बेटे की कहानी है, तो उनकी केमिस्ट्री के लिए आपको क्या क्या करना पड़ा था?
क्योंकि मेरे को इतना सोचना पड़ रहा है, तो जाहिर है कि कुछ भी नहीं करना पड़ा था, जो किया इन्होंने ही किया। और आप ही बताओ क्या किया आप दोनों ने, प्लीज।
अंजलि प्लीज।
झगड़ा किया बहुत, झगड़ा तो करते थे। नहीं, एक्चुअली जब स्क्रिप्ट पे काम शुरू हुआ तब भी, और जब हम मिले और वर्कशॉप्स हुई, एक बात कहीं थी अंदर जो दैट दिस इज़ नॉट गोइंग टू बी अ टिपिकल मदर एंड सन रिलेशनशिप, दे आर गोइंग टू बी फ्रेंड्स। ये दोस्त हैं क्योंकि उसकी ज़िंदगी में यही है और उसकी ज़िंदगी में है उसके दोस्त, बट फॉर सरगम ही कनु इज़ हर बेस्ट फ्रेंड एंड ऑल्सो वाइस वर्सा। तो बहुत ही इक्वल रिलेशनशिप था, ऐसा नहीं था कि ये मेरा बच्चा है या उम्र से कम है, तो यू नो इक्वल था, नथिंग मोर देन दैट। और क्या,
I think very well put. If you get pregnated at 16 and give birth at 17, you'll only bring up a friend, not just a child. And all alone, if you're doing that, तो बहुत give and take होता है, especially if you're not provided for. उसके साथ आपको यहाँ मतलब survive भी करना है. हम सब survive करते हैं, आपको मालूम है कितना difficult है. So it that relationship was ब्यूटिफुल। एंड आई थिंक कैमरे के आगे इतना नहीं था जितना कैमरे के पीछे इनकी केमिस्ट्री डेवलप हुई थी। सो ऑलवेज गिविंग अ लॉट ऑफ टाइम टू ईच अदर, सो मैनी थिंग्स, वो ऑर्गेनिकली हुआ था, इतना कुछ प्लान था नहीं उसमें।
और ये आपकी पहली फिल्म है जिसमें आपने बच्चों से काम करवाया है, तो उनके साथ उनसे काम निकलवाने का एक्सपीरियंस कैसा रहा था?
देखिए, ये बहुत बड़ी गलतफहमी है, इन्होंने मेरे से काम निकलवाया ऐसा कहीं से भी नहीं है। मैंने इनसे काम निकलवाया, इन सब ने मिलके मेरे से बहुत काम निकलवाया, मेरे से बहुत मेहनत करवाई है, और मैंने इतनी मेहनत कभी नहीं की जितनी इन्होंने करवाई है। और एसेंशियली मैंने कभी इनको ये नहीं बोला कैसे करना है, ये जाते थे अपना। At best, my role as a director was, you know, एक फुटबॉल का मैच शुरू हो जाता है ना, तो जो मैनेजर होता है या कोच होता है वो बाहर ही बैठा रहता है फील्ड से, वो अंदर जाके खेल नहीं सकता। अंदर इन सब का हुनर था, कैसे बॉल को टैकल करें, कैसे पास करें एक दूसरे को, कैसे गोल मारें। और कोई आउट ऑफ कैरेक्टर जाता था तो मैं सीटी बजा देता था कि मतलब ऑफ साइड।
I remember like during the first visits, like once I went with the crew when sir was having a location reiki pe, and I came, we had to like climb up the hill and then come down, we came down and I was like, I'm feeling little I was troubled with this thing that how not to have this, that we are going there in that location, in that area, with our, you know, expensive cameras, and we are trying to be part of that landscape, and how to get rid of this thought that we are coming from some point of view, some position, with all these expensive equipments and whatever. So I was troubled with that, and I said this to him, I was like, I don't know how to, you know, gel, like I don't know how to dissolve this knot. So he said, it's not that, you know, it's about celebration as well. Aise nahi hai ke these people, like, they're living there, so that means there is heaviness, we are putting the heaviness on it, that okay, they're living there, blah blah blah. So it's about celebration, this film is about celebration, And that kind of stuck, that stayed with me throughout. And that's what we saw also when we were shooting. And also between this relationship, between my friend, my neighbor friend, everyone, his friends. So there was always this one thing of celebration that, okay, we are celebrating. Even if it's a small meal we are eating with khichdi, it's a celebration. So that's something that stayed also in this relationship and overall in everything what we were doing.
Jayanti sir, straight over here. So what made you change the release date of the film? It was supposed to release on 8th and now it is releasing on 15th. So
ye रिलीज का प्लान पहले 8 मार्च ही था, लेकिन हमारे पास एक फिल्म आई रेड चिलीज से जो हमारे फ्रेंड की है सुजय घोष बदला, वो हम 8 मार्च को रिलीज़ कर रहे हैं. तो हमने एक ही टीम हमारी काम करेगी दोनों पिक्चर पे, तो हमें लगा जैसे राकेश जी ने बताया ये बहुत आराम से फिल्म रिलीज़ करने वाली थी, इसलिए हमने बोला कि हम ही सेटल कर लेते हैं. तो एक वीक पुश किया हमने.
Rakesh ji, can you hear me?
Yeah.
See, I remember that one film of Kapoor, Raj Kapoor sahab, that you know, Ab Dil Hi Door Nahi. So have you taken some inspiration from that film, or because you know, there's a, as the message goes, you know, Ab Meri Arzi Sun Lo Jara. So is it like that? Because you know, reference wise, you must have shot this film because the children are going to approach PM. So something like that we can see, we can think of that.
मैं कान पकड़ने पड़ेंगे मेरे को. वो दैट्स वन ऑफ द ग्रेटेस्ट फिल्म्स एवर मेड ऑन इंडियन सिनेमा. अब दिल्ली दूर नहीं, बूट पॉलिश, जागते रहो. सो यस, आई हैव टेकन अ लॉट ऑफ इंस्पिरेशन.
बट यू आल्सो गुड, यू आर आल्सो वेरी गुड फिल्म मेकर, वी नो दैट आल्सो.
नो नो, नॉट रियली. बिसाइड द पॉइंट, सो इन माई ग्रोइंग अप इयर्स, ओके, देयर वाज वन टेलीविजन इन द नेबरहुड, जो फिर वो खिड़की खोल देते थे. हमारी पुरानी दिल्ली में ऐसे ही होता था, जो सबसे बड़ा मकान होता था, और फिर सब भीड़ भाड़ लग जाती थी. एंड आई रिमेंबर अब दिल्ली दूर नहीं और बूट पॉलिश एंड ऑल, वही रिपीट होती रहती थी एवरी संडे. एंड वी ग्रोन अप ऑन दोज फिल्म्स एंड टू ऑब्वियसली दे आर इंस्पिरेशन. एंड दो आंखें बारह हाथ एंड बंदनी एंड प्यासा कागज़ के फूल, दे आर ऑल पार्ट ऑफ a collective consciousness which now will change is clothes and come in the cinema today, or people who've grown up with that cinema. Yeah,
I do agree with you, because in the audiences change, the people, those who have gone at that age, you know, I mean, the times have changed now. So certainly you can take inspiration and you can make topically, you know, you can make. It's a very good topic, I know that. Jayanti Bhai, can you say, tell me, because you regularly keep on releasing films. This is very simple narration film, I believe, because it's a realistic, short and realistic locations. So, क्या आप इस फिल्म से business की क्या उम्मीद आपकी, कैसी और कितना आप बड़े वे में इसको करेंगे? Because आप तो बड़े बड़ी फिल्में distribute भी करते हो.
Business का तो हर फिल्म का अलग होता है, और उससे पहले तो ये बोलना चाहिए कि content अच्छा है और content को back करना चाहिए. बिजनेस की उम्मीद तो वैसे भी बॉक्स ऑफिस हम लोग बाद में ही देखते हैं कि जो होगी, रिलीज़ अच्छी होनी चाहिए सबसे पहले. और राकेश जी की फिल्म में ये बॉक्स ऑफिस में अच्छी गई है, ऐसा भी नहीं है. तो मुझे लगता है कि ये जो हमारे पास विंडो है वो ओपन विंडो है, 15 मार्च को कोई फिल्म नहीं है, तो बहुत अच्छा बिजनेस करेगी.
मिस्टर मेहरा, टूवर्ड्स योर लेफ्ट, जस्टिन हियर फ्रॉम पीटीआई हियर. Mr. Mehra, are there plans, perhaps set in motions, to have a special screening for the PM to see the film?
No, not at all. I think we don't have any such plans yet. But yeah, it's kind of become very fashionable to do that. So I would rather want to stay away from that.
Why? I mean, is there a particular reason?
Now you are going after it. You asked something, I very, very honestly replied to you. No, there are no whys. I don't feel, I feel the film is made for the people of the country, and somewhere I don't want to dilute that and use such a huge, such a big office. He's a very, very busy man and running the country, to take 3 hours of his time, which he could, I think, devote to some national and international policy, just because I want to promote a film. Wo mere ko kuch judge nahi raha. Haan, agar unka dekhne ka man hua, to it will be an honor. Yeah.
Thank you so much. Hello, Rakesh.
Mr. Mehra, this is Priyanka.
Hi. Towards your right.
Hi, Priyanka.
Oh, okay, hi. This is Priyanka from Indian Express. I wanted to ask you that, you know, you've worked with so many stars, from Mr. Bachchan to Aamir, and in this film you're working with these wonderful children, but who were more difficult to handle as a director, those like big stars or these kids?
Anjali.
Why so?
Woman.
Anjali, do you have anything to say on that?
No, I have nothing to say. I take everything. Whatever he says, yes, I was trouble. I was a big trouble.
Right. No, I've been completely very, very fortunate. My first film, when I stepped into it, and I always say that Amitji was there and he gave birth to a director. And if you see, there was Amitji, then it became Aamir, then became Abhishek, then became Farhan, then became Harsh, and now it's Om and Anjali. So age group choti hoti jari. So there must be some reason. Abhi wapas shuru karna padega.
Hello, Rakesh sir. Straight ahead over here.
Yeah.
Sir, a little to your left.
Yeah.
Yeah. Russell here from Movified. What I would want to know, it seems that the film has been shot in a lot of real-life locations, and you're shot in a lot of slums, it seems like. So what was that experience like in a shooting in a raw and a rough and gritty environment like that?
It was not shot in a lot of real location. It was only shot on real locations. And it was only shot in real homes. We didn't even create a set for the interiors. Now what happens is, in a situation like this, yes, a crew has to, they have to adjust a lot. Spatially it's very challenging for the DOP, but nobody wants to compromise on the work. So they would put lights in very odd positions, and you can imagine if there's a 10 feet by 15 feet room and you're doing a night scene, quite a few night scenes in the film. What it is actually very difficult is for the actors. You know, because they cannot show that discomfort. We can still be behind the camera and cursing ourselves and sweating and be in all kind of moods, but they have to stay in that character. They cannot let that environment affect them. So I think it was really, really very, very challenging for the actors to pull this off, and hats off to them, absolutely.
Also, sir, you said that one day while riding back after shooting Bhag Milka Bhag, you saw this site and you got an idea to make this film. But what about the characters? Because the characters look so authentic. Did you base it on some real life people?
No, I didn't get the idea to make that film. That stayed in my subconscious. You know, I'm from a Air Force school, Balbati Air Force in Delhi. And every day when I used to enter the school, there was a MiG-21 plane there. 20 years, 30 years later in life, MiG-21s are crashing. So it moved me, and I made Rang De Basanti, and I saw this thing. So this storyline is not mine, it belongs to Manoj. He brought the storyline, and then Hussein collaborated, and both of us took it further. And from a simple storyline, which is beautiful, that this kid writes a letter to the Prime Minister, we took it to the next level, built it around, got the rape in, got the holy factor in, got revolved everything around the mother and son, and got a beautiful a third kind of a romance into it. Can, in a place like this, can there be a very progressive kind of romance? Not the cliche definition of romance. Can there be something more? Can there be soulmates? And do you actually have to be married to be romantic? And stuff like that. And then most importantly, the spirit, what Anjali was talking about. You know, kids are amazing because every day they're discovering something new in life. So I started seeing the film through their eyes also a lot, because for them it was wonderful. So yeah, all that.
Hi, Anjali, straight towards you. Anjali, looking at your filmography, and especially your Hindi filmography, you have mostly associated yourself with movies that, you know, either have a strong social subtext or, you know, have an artistic bend towards them. Is it something very, you're very conscious about selecting scripts, you know, which reflect, you know, this zone of cinema? Or are you looking forward to doing, like, all sorts of, even mainstream Bollywood masala, all of that? So just about that, I wanted to ask you.
See, these answers will keep changing, you know, like every day the answers change with all of us. Like we think that we are that yesterday and today we are something else. So a simple answer to this is when I fought with my family to get into a drama school when I was 16, nobody paid me, you know, it was my choice. I ran away from my my home, from Nashik. To study, to become an artist, because that's what I wanted to become. And then I studied, and then I studied more, and then I got into films. I studied direction for a while in National School of Drama. Then films just happened, and it opened up a different artist. It gave me a different medium. And then the film kind of happened to me, and I went along with it. So choices are, of course, made consciously, unconsciously, especially with the subject, because I remember saying this to Rakesh sir as well, and also to myself, to know the fact that one day on a set is something where I give my breath. You know, I'm breathing there. I'm giving my sweat. I'm living that one day on the set. So I want to be on a set. I want to be around the people. Forget the set, forget the work. I want to be in situations in life where I really want to be. Like, you know, this is part of my life. This is part of your life. We are sharing life right now in this moment. So it better be good. It better be, you know, whatever. So that's with work. My work is my life and the life is work. It's both ways. I don't know if I answered your question. So if the Bollywood masala thing becomes part of my life, if I feel that, okay, I'll have fun doing it, I will, or I don't know. The answers keep changing. Yeah.
Thanks a lot. Rakesh, sir, I had a small question for you. You know, like when we do even simple Google searches on the plight of open defecation in India, often we come across these statements that come from either the municipal bodies or the chief minister or the government itself that, you know, Mumbai has become open defecation free, and even rural and urban Maharashtra, you know, this problem doesn't exist, which renders your film completely fictional, although people over here living here will have very different anecdotes and reality issues to share. And it's kind of ironic that, you know, the people who are responsible for it are claiming it doesn't exist, and there's this attitude of denial, while cinema, which is a fictional medium, has to take the job of showing us reality. So how do you feel about that?
What's the question?
My question is that, you know, there's this attitude of denial, especially with the issue of open defecation. We've had statements made at separate occasions previous year that it's not a problem, that it doesn't exist, and the state is very near to, you know, eradicating this problem very completely. So do you agree with that? Because obviously your film points to a very different reality.
Come on.
Thank you so much.
That's right, the answer.
Hello, Rakesh.
Last
sir?
Question.
Rakesh.
No, it doesn't fly like that. It's not that. And a lot of my friends here from the media have been to the location where we shot.
Yeah.
One of our locations, you know, when those four of them are sitting in that location on top of the hill where the planes cross you, we would shoot every day and for a couple, like 1 week of schedule was on top of the hill. And I still remember this 90-year-old or 95-year-old lady whose back was completely bent would climb up on the hill because her coli was there and would walk from here to here. It would take her like 10 minutes to walk, and we would stop shooting. and she was going to defecate there on the top of the hill. So I don't think, and once again, this film is not about open defecation. That's not my job. My job is to somewhere touch you and touch myself, because I felt like that is how to change this consciousness towards women and their safety. Whether rapes happen while they're defecating, you take a plot point, so you have to weave a story around it. But overall, it's just an open reality out there. The question of forcing yourself on somebody else if you're physically stronger. I don't think if you're not physically stronger, you could have done that any other way. So it's I won't even insult the animals. People say it's animalistic behavior. I don't think even animals behave like that.
Rakesh, sir, you have built more than 100 toilets in a slum area. Did you get any political help? And elections are coming near. So, mere pyare Prime Minister, aapko kya lagta hai, kitna impactful rahega ye film, kitni impactful rehne wali hai audiences pe, aur kitna effect karegi elections pe?
Nahin, kuch bhi nahin effect karegi.
Right.
Karna bhi nahin chahiye. Filmon ka kaam hi nahin hai ki wo elections pe impact kare. एक जब कोई एक फिल्म बनती है वो हाँ जाहिर है कि वो इट शुड डू वेरी वेल ऑन द फ्राइडे एंड द कमिंग फ्राइडेज एंड होल्ड इटसेल्फ एंड गिव द मनी बैक टू द इन्वेस्टर्स बट माय एंडेवर हैज टू मेक मूवीज विच कैन बी परपेचुअल कैन यू नो बिकॉज हम सबकी बेस्ट नॉवेल्स बेस्ट गाने बेस्ट फिल्में हम ये थोड़ी बोलते हैं मैंने वो उस हफ्ते में देखा था उस हफ्ते में सुना था अब हमें कुछ नहीं मालूम वो फिल्म 1960 में बनी थी 70 में बनी थी 80 में 90 में बट वो हमारी प्यारी फिल्में हैं सो कहीं अगर आप वो क्लब में आप बहुत लकी हुए और सब कुछ अच्छा हो गया और वो उस क्लब में एंटर हो गए जहां आपका काम परपेचुअल हो जाता है तो मेरे ख्याल से कामयाबी वहाँ वो कामयाबी भी बहुत ज़रूरी है
Right, thank you so much. That brings us to the end of the Q&A round. And thank you. Please do enjoy the film on the 15th. Thank you, Rakesh sir. Thank you, Jayanti sir. Anjali, Natu, and you, congratulations. Congratulations.
Can we see the trailer once more?
Yes, why not, sir? Once more.
Right side, yeah. For Bollywood news update, please subscribe our YouTube channel Bollywood Dangle, and please don't forget to press bell icon.